Okay, thank you. Join.
Hello and good morning, everyone, to Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, Asian Jural Conclave 2021-22, that is going to be hosted by Lloyd Law College, along with 7th Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, Asian Mooting Competition India Round, which is going to be held over here today, Saturday, 26th of November, 2021, to Sunday, 28th November, 2021. We all welcome the presence of all our dignitaries, all our esteemed guests. Especially, I welcome the presence of Honorable Mr. Justice S. Thurai Raja, Judge, Supreme Court of Sri Lanka. I welcome the presence of Mr. R. Venkatramani, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India, Co-Chairperson, Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, Asian Jural Conclave. I welcome the presence of Professor Dr. S. Siva Kumar, Sir, Senior Professor, Indian Law Institute, New Delhi, former member, Law Commission of India, honorary Asian Jural Conclave Administrator. I welcome the presence of Professor Dr. Lisa P. Lukos, Professor, University School of Law and Legal Studies, Guru Govind Singh Indraprastha Institute, New Delhi, Treasurer Milad, National Administrator, India. I welcome the presence of Mr. Manohar Tharani, President, Lloyd Law College, Chairperson, Founding Committee, Professor N.R. Madhava Menon Jural Conclave. I welcome the presence of our special address delivering guest of honor, Professor Dr. Dilip Uke, Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National University, Mumbai. I welcome you all on board, all the students, all the participants, all the judges of the event, all the guests. We are extremely delighted to have the presence of all of you today on the esteemed day of beginning our most important program, our festival of academic festival, which we always conduct in our campus. The name of Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, sir, is not something which is unknown in the legal fraternity in India and abroad. The name of Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, sir, is something which is known, read, and completely delighted in a way that everyone, every academic in India is looking to be, to see Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, sir, as the guru and mentor. Every legal education institution, be it a traditional or modern, always conceive the ideas experiment the ideas of Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, sir. We are delighted to have the name of Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, sir, for this esteemed event, and we are able to garner the support of all the legal fraternity, from bar, from bench, from institutions, from students, from all people of fraternity. We are very delighted and very thankful to have the support of all kinds from everyone. I would now request my team member, Ms. Vandana Nair, to kindly speak the short biography of Professor Dr. N.R. Madhava Menon, sir. Ms. Vandana Nair.
A very good morning to all of you. A few words about Padma Bhushan late Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, who walked the earth between 1935 to 2019. Professor Menon qualified BSc, BL, MA, LLM, and PhD, enrolled as an advocate in Kerala High Court in the year 1956, and later joined the faculty of Aligarh Muslim University in 1960. In 1965, he moved to Delhi University and became professor and head of the Campus Law Center. Meanwhile, he also served as principal Government Law College, Pondicherry, and secretary Bar Council of India Trust. In 1986, Professor Menon took up the challenging mission from Bar Council of India to set up the first national law university in Bangalore with 5-year integrated LLB, and later became its founding vice chancellor. For decades, he worked for reforming and revolutionizing the legal education not only in India, but also in the SAARC nations. He was the founder vice chancellor of the National University of Juridical Sciences, Calcutta, from 1998 to the year 2003, and the founder director of National Judicial Academy, Bhopal, till 2006. On retirement in 2006, the Government of India appointed him as member of the Commission on State Center Relations from 2006 till 2010. He was also chairman of the Indian Statistical Institute, Kolkata, and of the Center for Development Studies, Trivandrum. He chaired the Government of India Committee to draft a national policy on criminal justice and the Committee on Equal Opportunity Commission. He was member of the Committee on Criminal Justice Reforms and the Committee on Restructuring of Higher Education in India. He served 2 terms as member of the Law Commission of India. Professor Menon was decorated with several awards by government and professional bodies. To name a few, the International Bar Association honored him with Living Legend of Law Award in the year 1994. The Rotary Club with Vocational Excellence Award in the year 1992. The Society of Indian Law Firms with the Best Law Teacher Award in the year 2009. The ET Now Group with National Education Leadership Award in 2013. And the Government of India with Padma Shri, the highest civilian award for outstanding public services in the year 2003. He was elected chairman of Commonwealth Legal Education Association in 1997. Professor Menon engaged in professional development, training of lawyers and law teachers under the aegis of the IBA chair at the National Law School. He was chairman of the Menon Institute of Legal Advocacy Training, MILAD, an educational charity at Trivandrum. He was member of governing boards of many universities. He authored over 12 books on legal education, legal profession, legal aid, judicial training, and administration of justice. The book titled Turning Point in 2010 is a biography of the life and work of Professor Menon. The life, achievements, and tireless, unmatchable contributions for more than 6 decades of Professor Menon, the father of modern legal education, as an academician, institution builder, and a socially committed jurist, is being commemorated by SILF Milad through its annual Best Law Teacher Awards, instituted in Professor Menon's name since the year 2009.
Thank you so much, Ms. Vandana Nair, for a delightful reading of the biography of Padma Bhushan late Professor Dr. N.R. Madhava Menon sir, I would now, with the permission of Professor Dr. S. Siva Kumar sir, Honorary Asian Jural Conclave Administrator, with the permission of sir and with the permission of our chief guest of the program, we start the program now. Sir?
Yes, please.
Thank you, sir. I would now request my team members of the anchoring committee to kindly start the inaugural function. Thank you. Mr. Karthike.
A very good morning to all present here. I, Karthike Chaturvedi, feel privileged to welcome you all on behalf of the organizing committee, management, staff, and students of Lloyd Law College to the inaugural function of Professor N.R. Madhava Menon Asian Jural Conclave 2021-22, which comprises of 7th Professor N.R. Madhava Menon Asian Jural Conclave, India Round. It is with immense pleasure that we welcome our esteemed guests. First of all, I would like to welcome our chief guest, Honorable Mr. Justice Sitambaram Pillai Thurai Raja, President's Counsel, is a lawyer and a sitting junior justice of the Supreme Court of Sri Lanka. To start with, we will have the welcome address by the president of our college, Mr. Manohar Thairani, chairperson, founding committee, Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, Asian Jural Conclave. Briefings of the competition will be given by Professor Dr. Lisa P. Lukos, Professor Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, University School of Law and Legal Studies, Treasurer, Menon Institute of Legal Advocacy Training, National Administrator, India. The introductory address will be given by Professor Dr. S. Sivakumar, Senior Professor, Indian Law Institute, former member, Law Commission of India, Honorable Asian Jural Conclave Administrator. After that, Mr. R. Venkat Ramani, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India, will apprise us about the N.R. Madhava Menon Asian Jural Conclave and the mooting competition. Followed by a special address by Professor Dr. Dilip Ukai, Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai. And then the most awaited inaugural address by our chief guest, Honorable Mr. Justice S. Thurai Raja, Judge, Supreme Court of Sri Lanka. To wrap up the event, we will have a vote of thanks by Professor Dr. Mohammad Salim, Director, Lloyd Law College, General Coordinator, Steering Committee, Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, Asian Jural Conclave.
Good morning, everyone present here. I, Aditi Srivastava, happily introduce. Good morning, everyone present here. I, Aditi Srivastava, happily introduce Mr. Manohar Thairani, President, Lloyd Law College and Chairperson, Founding Committee, Professor N.R. Madhav Menon, Asian Jural Conclave. Mr. Thairani is a chartered accountant by profession. Sir established Lloyd Law College in year 2003 to facilitate quality education area of law. Under his guidance, the Law College has successfully endeavored to create for itself extraordinary position in area of legal education in India. I would like to invite Mr. Manohar Thairani, President, Lloyd Law College, to formally welcome our guests and the participants.
Thank you so much. Respected chief guest, Honorable Mr. Justice S. Thurai Raja, sir, Judge Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, our guest of honor, Professor Dr. Dalip UK, Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai. Sri R. Venkatri, sir, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India, Co-Chairperson, Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, Asian Jural Conclave. Professor Dr. S. Sivakumar, sir, Senior Professor, Indian Law Institute, former member, Law Commission of India, Chairman Milad, and Honorary Administrator, Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, Asian Jural Conclave. Dr. Lisa V. Lucas, Professor, GGSF University, Treasurer Menard, and National Administrator, Professor N. R. Madhav Menon, Asian Development Day. Eminent dignitaries, Director Sir, Deputy Director Sir, faculty members, and dear participants. Good morning, and a very, very warm welcome to all of you. It's with immense pleasure that I welcome all of you to the Professor N. R. Madhav Menon Asian Jewel Conclave, India Round 2021-22. It's indeed a great privilege and blessing for us to be a host of this conclave. At the onset, I'd like to express my sincere gratitude to our beloved guru and mentor, Padma Bhushan Professor Dr. N. R. Madhav Menon, sir, for entrusting us with conducting this international jewel conclave with his name and giving us the confidence to move ahead to take this competition to further heights. We are now staunchly and resolutely organizing this jewel conclave as a humble and sincere effort and mission to take forward Menon sir's vision under the guidance of Professor Dr. S. Kumar sir, Chairman Milan, and Venkatri sir, who are steadfast and committed in taking forward the legacy of Menon sir. This event, aiming at the development of the professional and academic skills of law students, are organized in collaboration with Milan and SILF. The competition has attained great popularity among the law students in India and other South Asian countries, with multiple national rounds and entering its seventh edition. It's a great privilege for us to welcome the eminent legal luminaries who are present here to be a part of this flagship event. And I would like to welcome you all to the Indian round of Professor N. R. Madhav Menon Asian Jewel Conclave. We are extremely honored today by the gracious presence of Honorable Mr. Justice S. Rai Raja Sir, Judge Supreme Court of Sri Lanka. Honorable Lordship had graciously agreed to be the chief guest at the inauguration today. Lordship has wholeheartedly extended his support to all our academic efforts and is an inspiration to all of us. Respected Lordship, your support and mentoring, it is an immense privilege for us, and Lordship's presence here is an instance of his commitment to nurture and inspire our younger generation lawyers and students. Honorable Lordship, on behalf of all present here, we extend a very, very warm welcome to your Lordship. I extend our heartiest welcome to Professor Dr. Dalip UK, Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai. Sir is one of the most distinguished academicians of the country, with more than three decades of academic experience, and has admirable achievements, including international fellowships, and was conferred Best Academician by the Indian National Bar Association, New Delhi, in 2019. It's an honor to welcome Professor UK to the inaugural session, and I'm sure that our students and faculty members will be inspired by you. Dear sir, on behalf of all present here, we extend a very, very warm welcome to you, sir. Welcome, sir. Shri R. Venkatri, sir, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India, and Co-Chairperson, Professor N. R. Madhav Menon, Asian Jewel Conclave, is a true well-wisher and advisor to our college. Sir has been keenly involved in the organization of this event and always extended his wholehearted support and guidance to take forward the entire program to get organized. We feel extremely blessed and indebted for all the support and guidance Sir extends to us. Dear sir, a very, very warm welcome to you. Professor Dr. S. Sivakumar, sir, Senior Professor, IIT, former member of Law Commission India, Chairman Milan, and Honorary Administrator Professor N. R. Madhav Menon, is a very, very dear friend of the Institute. Sir has been continuously guiding us and supporting us in the growth of the Institute. It has to be stated that Sir is a driving force behind the whole initiative and has meticulously planned and organized the event to strive towards a goal Madhav Menon Sir has raised while conceptualizing this competition. Sir, it is an honor and privilege to work with you under your guidance for the successful conduct of this program. And I extend a very, very warm welcome to yourself. I also extend a warm welcome to Dr. Lisa P. Lucas, National Administrator, India. Lisa Madam has been guiding the conduct of this event through her valuable inputs and suggestions in all the 7 editions of this competition. She has worked very hard and with full commitment for the conduct of the program, which is very, very admirable. A very, very warm welcome to you, Madam. I also take the opportunity to welcome our very own passionate and committed director, Professor Dr. Salim Sir, our deputy director, Mr. Akhilesh Sir, Mr. Robin Sir, for putting their heart and soul into the service of the Institute and for dedicatedly working for its upliftment, excellence, and perpetual growth. I'd also like to welcome the team of Professor Namneet and very passionate and our committed student coordinators. A very, very warm welcome to all of you. The adjudicators for the present competition drawn from legal, academia, bar, and bench. I extend a heartfelt welcome to all of you. I wholeheartedly extend a warm welcome to all the student participants present today. The diversity and vibrance of the gathering ensures awareness about the South Asian legal systems, pedagogies, and cultural exchange. This year, we have 38 teams, and this high number of participants from all over India truly reflects the usefulness and relevance of this competition. I applaud the hard work put in by students and assure them a fair and transparent competition. I wish you all the best luck. I assure you that my team and I am available round the clock for your services. Please feel free to approach us for any help. I hope that this event inspires ideas and visions which can help transform the face of our country's legal education in alignment with the vision of our guide and mentor, Professor Dr. N.R. Madhavanan, sir. With these thoughts and wishes, I will once again welcome and assure all present today to this moving competition. A very, very warm welcome to all of you.
Thank you, sir, for the welcome address. I, Bhavani Singh Rajput, take the privilege to welcome Professor Dr. Lisa P. Lucas Tajra Milat, who's a professor in University School of Law and Legal Studies, Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, Delhi. Professor Dr. Lisa P. Lucas is the Member Secretary of Commonwealth Law Reform Commission and Secretary, Commonwealth Legal Education Association, India. Professor Dr. Lisa P. Lucas have received many accolades and awards, including Rashtrapati Award for Guides, Venus International Women 20 Award 2021 for Outstanding Women Researcher in Law, Professor, recipient of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan Distinguished Professor Award 2021 in Intellectual Property Right Law, Academic Brand Award 2021 for Outstanding Faculty of the Year 2021, and Global Faculty Award 2020. Now, would request Professor Dr. Lisa P. Lucas to give the briefing of the competition.
Thank you, Bhavani. Honorable Mr. Justice S. Thurai Raja, Judge Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, our esteemed Chief Guest, Professor Dr. Dilip Uke, Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai, our Guest of Honor, Mr. R. Venkat Ramani, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India, and Co-Chairperson of the Conclave, Professor Dr. S. Shivakumar, Senior Professor, Indian Law Institute, and Honorary Administrator, Asian Jural Conclave, Mr. Manohar Tehrani, President, Lloyd Law College and Co-Chairperson of the Jural Conclave, Professor Dr. Muhammad Salim, Director, Lloyd Law College and General Coordinator of the Jural Conclave, Dr. Akhilesh Kumar Khan, Deputy Director, Lloyd Law College and Secretary General of the Asian Jural Conclave, Mr. Navneet Kumar, Faculty Coordinator, Advocate Anand Maria, Advocate Robin Jacob, eminent guests, respected judges, faculty colleagues, dear Boot Court participants, members of organizing committee, dear students, ladies and gentlemen, a very warm good morning to all of you. I consider it a great privilege to be part of this renowned competition, which has gained unique acclaim in the past 7 years. The competition, which began in 2015 for SAARC countries, under the personal guidance and patronage of Professor N.R. Madhava Menon, has now expanded to the entire Asian region. It's interesting to note its growth by year by year. Initially, the event consisted of only Mooting and Law Students Conference. In the second edition, Judicial Colloquium was added to the program, which got expanded as South Asian Colloquium in the later years, witnessing enthusiastic participation of judges from Supreme Court and High Court divisions of various South Asian countries. Later on, research papers presentation of faculty members also became an essential component in the event. In this way, it's a unique event where bar and bench, faculty and students all engage themselves in the intellectual exercise of critically evaluating various legal concepts and legal systems and propose constructive suggestions for legal reforms. It's indeed a matter of self-satisfaction and pride that during the previous years, the Mooting would address significant and the then contemporary legal issues such as refugee laws, climate change, indigenous people's rights, women rights, sustainable and renewable energy, disaster management, gender issues, etc., all of which are still having relevance even today. We could publish 3 books through international publishers from the proceedings of the conference and colloquium. These books are on the themes law and morality, disaster management and indigenous people's rights. 2 more books titled Gender Justice, A South Asian Perspective and Public Law and Governance are in the press getting ready for their release. Though COVID has created impediments for a physical round, in the last year too, we organized virtual competitions successfully. This year, we are embarking to the whole Asian region as Asian Jural Conclave. It's only with the support and guidance of our patrons, the honorable judges from SAR countries, and the faculty members and lawyers who always lend their helping hand and academic partnering, we are able to do this. I would like to acknowledge the unparalleled guidance and support of Honorable Justice Turi Raja in the previous editions as well. Professor S. Shivakumar sir, Venkat Ramani sir, and Manohar Therani sir guide us constantly and selflessly by putting the wind in our sails with an aim to establish the Indian legal system as the top legal education system in Asian region. And incidentally, with this purposeful idea, Lloyd is investing great legal minds together in the, to present the task of fulfilling the dream of Professor Menon. Professor N.R. Madhava Menon Asian Jural Conclave 21-22 will consist of 2 stages, India Round and the Asian Round. From this competition, India can nominate up to 7 teams for Asian Round. 4 regions of Asia can select up to 6 teams, wherein the South Asian countries such as Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bhutan and Maldives can select up to 4 teams. The Asian Round will take place from 25th to 27th February 2022. The parallel Law Students Conference will facilitate an interactive platform where students from Asian region can exchange their knowledge for intellectual gains and professional development. Undoubtedly, this will help students in understanding and comparing the legal systems in various countries. This year, the topics for the Law Students Conference and Judicial Colloquium are Technology and Future of Law in Asia, and New Asia and Diverse Constitutional Conversions, respectively. Lordship, our distinguished adjudicators are joining us from Kashmir to Kerala and Arunachal Pradesh to Gujarat. What a great pleasure and what a great honor to host the whole nation in this event. In the aggregate, Lloyd Law College is experiencing a successful developing institution, reaching to the top by these innovative programs and working with the learning and experiencing technique where students can explore legal intellect and other legal systems of education. This program will definitely achieve all its goals and objectives, but with your cooperation and support. As Lloyd Law College tries to keep its promise and commitment towards Professor Menon to extend and expand its programs to larger geographic canvas by investing in ideas of Asian Jural Conclave, I am hopeful that the event would bring its desired result to all stakeholders in India and other Asian countries. Dear teams, this is your day. Encounter it enthusiastically. Experience the joy of competition. Let the victory be yours. By welcoming you all once again for joining the Legal Intellectual League, I remain. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving us the brief. I gladly announce that we have amongst us Professor Dr. S. Sivakumar, Senior Professor at Indian Law Institute, Delhi. Dr. Sivakumar was member 21st Law Commission of India 2016 to 2018. Currently, Dr. Sivakumar is the Honorary Chairman of the Commonwealth Law Reform Commission. He did his BSc, LLM, and PhD, and his specialization is in administrative law and media law. His area of interest includes constitutional law, human rights, IPR, ADR, and clinical legal education. Dr. Sivakumar is the recipient of National Law Day Award 2008 for his contribution in legal education reform activities. Sir has taught for several years in prestigious educational institutions, including National University of Juridical Science, Kolkata, and Hidayatullah National Law University, Raipur. He was the officiating director of Indian Law Institute from January 5th, 2009 to July 10, 2009, and was director in charge from August 18, 2011 to July 31st, 2013 of the Institute. He has been conferred honoris causa for his immense contribution in the field of law and mass communication. He has published many articles in reputed national and international research journals and chapters for several books. He has delivered several memorials and endowment lectures, keynote addresses, presented several papers, and chaired sessions in national and international conferences. His works on criminal justice administration in Chhattisgarh and criminal justice administration in Kerala have been published as books. He is the vice president and trustee of Commonwealth Legal Education Reform Association, CLEA, London, and the president of CLEA South Asia. He is the project director of Project on Police Systems India series and planning to publish as books into 35 volumes. As honorary administrator of Professor N.R. Madhava Menon Asian Jural Conclave Program, he is taking a lead to encourage co-curricular activities for law students and legal educators of the Asian region. Sir, I request you to kindly deliver the introductory address.
Sir, you are not audible.
Sir, your voice is not coming.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Now it's okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ujwal, for a long introduction. Honorable Mr. Justice S. Thurairaja, Judge Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, our chief guest of today's program and dear friend of this unique initiative. My dearest friend, Professor Dr. Dilip O.K., Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National Law University. Our esteemed guide, Mr. R. Venkatramani, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India and Co-Chairperson of the Conclave, Mr. Manohar Thairani, President, Lloyd Law College, Secretary, Milat, and Chairperson of this Conclave, my colleague, Professor Dr. Lisa P. Lukos, Professor, IP University and Deputy Administrator of the Conclave and National Administrator, India. Mr. Ramesh Menon, son of Professor, our Guru, Professor N.R. Madhav Menon. Professor Dr. Muhammad Salim, Director, Lloyd Law College, and the person who is driving this entire event, the general coordinator of the conclave, Dr. Aglish Khan, Deputy Director, Lloyd Law College and Secretary General of this conclave, distinguished guests, esteemed panel of judges all over the country, dear participants of this competition, my fellow colleagues in the faculty, especially the chief coordinators, Mr. Navneet, Mr. Robin Jacob, and others, faculty from Lloyd Law College, dear students, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to you all. It is honor, it is an honor to have you all here in the virtual platform of Professor N.R. Madhav Menon Asian Conclave, wherein we conduct mooting competition India round consecutively for the 7th year. I feel proud that despite adverse situations owing to pandemic and pollution, still we could organize this event through virtually. It is in admiration of the encompassing spirit, international perspective, vitality and vision of the chief guest, Mr. Justice Thurai Raja, Judge Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, whose presence is making this event a greater cause. My friend, Professor Dilip Uke, Vice Chancellor of Maharashtra National Law University, is representing our academic community in this program. I especially applaud the initiation of Mr. Manohar Tairani and Lloyd Law College working to make the mission and vision of our mentor and guru, Professor N.R. Madhav Menon, a success and an availability for all, not only in India, but within the South Asian countries who had been participating since 2015. This year, with the inauguration of India Round of Asian Dural Conclave, today we look forward to discussing the relevant aspect of the legal system of governance, especially those relating to social media and privacy by way of online moot court competition. There have been successful and innovative reforms brought in the Indian legal education system by Padma Bhushan Professor N.R. Madhav Menon. His selfless contributions was the inspiration to the Lloyd Law College, which ultimately gave birth to the South Asian mooting and now to Asian mooting competition and Dural Conclave. Professor Menon had largely contributed to the legal education even after his official tenure of services, as he contributed to the active through various training programs for judges, faculty members, and advocates under the auspices of Professor Menon Institute of Legal Advocacy and Training, shortly MILAT, of which he was the founder chairperson. To his great initiation, MILAT, with his well-wishers and students, including our esteemed senior advocate, R. Venkatramani, Professor Lisa, is taking the legacy beyond and in association with premier institution and organization of our country and abroad, such as Lloyd Law College, Indian Law Institute, SILF, Societies of Indian Law Firm, Bar Association of India, Commonwealth Legal Education Association, SARC Law, etc., to organize various programs of competitions, training program, summer school, colloquiums, and along with this, in-depth research studies and project like Police India Project and the publication as mentioned by our national administrator. Coming to this program, first Professor N.R. Madhav Menon's South Asia Mooting Competition and Students Conference was held in 2015, qualifying various countries from India for participation in the South Asia round. Honorable Supreme Court judges from India and abroad, esteemed legal luminaries with academics had been supporting this task since then every year to achieve the aim of having India as a leader in the field of legal education. Taking this experience and demand from various quarters, this year we are revisiting the initiative taken by and with Professor N.R. Madhav Menon in a virtual platform consisting of three separate holistic program, including mooting competition, students conference, judicial colloquium, which includes research paper presentation by members of faculty and researchers under one head of Professor N.R. Madhav Menon Asian Jural Conclave 21-22 for legal academia and legal personnel luminaries in India and abroad. As already Professor Lisa pointed out, we are expected to organize this Asian event from 25th to 27th of February on a very two important topic. We are going to deliberate in colloquium as well as students conference, that is technology as well as the diverse constitutional conversation respectively. This platform in the form of Jural Conclave is initiated within the vision of making various countries of Asian continent come together and promote the legal system of education and give a better picture of law and justice across the Asian region. I am sure that this deliberation will help the students and the faculty in understanding the legal system and assess its strength and weakness in various Asian countries. I believe that there cannot be a better promotion of the ideas associated with what Professor Menon by his life and service. By this way, we aspire to advance the values of legal systems and understanding of law and justice techniques by way of intellectual debates and deliberation. Last but the least, I express my sincere gratitude to Professor Dr. Mohammed Salim and Dr. Agilesh Kumar Khan, the vibrant faculty members and enthusiastic students of Lloyd Law College, for their hard work and commitment to organize this event very meticulously. Every time, it is a pleasure to associate with you. I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind words. I, Sarah Sharma, feels privileged to have among us Mr. R. Venkatramani, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India, Co-Chairperson, Professor N.R. Madhav Menon, Asian Jural Conclave. He is appointed as a member, Law Commission of India in 2010. Mr. R. Venkatramani has been appearing for the State of Tamil Nadu as a Special Senior Counsel for the past 12 years and also acting as a Special Senior Counsel for the State of Andhra Pradesh. He is also retained by the Tamil Nadu Electricity Board to represent its cases before the Supreme Court and the Electricity Appellate Tribunal, New Delhi. Being engaged by the Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Railways, and Ministry of Health and Family Welfare as Special Counsel. He has also acted as a standing counsel for various universities and public sector corporations, counsel for Supreme Court in matters pertaining to employees of the court, co-opted member of the expert group constituted by the Ministry of the Minority Affairs to examine and determine the structure and functions of an Equal Opportunity Commission. He was invited to be the member of the Committee of Indian Council for Medical Research, member cum office bearer of several lawyers' associations, life member of Indian Society of International Law, resource person of the Society for its annual summer courses, and actively participating in the projects of the Society, member, Indian Law Institute. He has also served as a law member in the expert group on welfare legislations set up by the Planning Commission of India in the year 1990. Member of the South Asian Task Force on Judiciary, consisting of the members of SAARC nations, on the panel of the jury invited for public hearings on child labor at New Delhi in 1997 and on crimes on women at Bangalore in 1999. Member of the Subcommittee on Directive Principles of State Policy, constituted by the Commission, constituted by the Commission of the Reviewing the Working Constitution and the Chairmanship of Justice M.N. Venkatachalya. He has been invited to speak at the workshop jointly organized by the United Nations Commission for Higher Rights, Human Rights and International Commissions of Jurists at Geneva on 4th to 6th March 2001. He was also invited to be involved in the Nepalese Constitution drafting, an experience sharing exercise in 2008. He has several publications to his credit, and the list is endless. Moreover, he is currently working on scope and application of international instruments in domestic lawmaking and judicial enforcement, and a book on constitutional rights and jurisprudence. Sir, may I kindly request you to address the gathering.
Sir, your voice is not coming. Sir, your voice is not coming.
Sir, you are muted. 1 second. I'll just now it is
fine.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much. Hearty and warm welcome to Justice S. Thurairaja, Judge, Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, whom I personally admire, and he has been a great support to this event, traveling all the way relentlessly to our shores and being part of the event. Thank you, sir, for accepting your invitation to be part of the event today. Let me also welcome Vice Chancellor Dr. Dilip Uke, and I'm sure with the presence of more and more Vice Chancellors as part of these ongoing events, we will be encouraged to take more important ways of advancing and expanding these events. More importantly, let me welcome and our students logged in to make their vibrant presence felt beyond the screen. Every year, when we congregate on the occasion of Professor Menon, remembering moot event, I continue to feel the importance of remembering and honoring him for several reasons, deeply connected to legal education and its seminal purpose, namely administration of justice. To every student who have shown their keenness to be part of this multidimensional events taking place, I wish to say that it is by paying tributes to and honoring the ancient traditions of Guru that we grow. And that's how I invoke the blessings of Professor Menon and seek his continued invisible presence. The idea of SAARC law, with all its rich contributions to the fields of justice in SAARC regions, to the assemblage of legal professionals, has now almost come of age. it appears to many of us who have seen its contributions that it is time to conceptualize something larger in consonance with the emerging global realities. The world is still a divided phenomenon. Continental distinctions continue to impact global compacts and global human welfare. Inequalities continue. Race and creed hang around somewhere and plague our common concerns. The idea of constitution and rule of law have, however, percolated to the far reaches of the globe. Thus, sprouting has its slow but visible demonstrations. Legal education and legal systems began to now see new amalgamations and cross-fertilizations. We as former students of Professor Menon, and being fortunate to be part of nurturing Professor Menon's SAARC MOOC competition, began contemplating expansion of this event, more encouraged by the presence and support of judges and academicians from all the SAARC countries. The excited birth of Asian Jural Conclave is a product of gestations over a period. As I was contemplating as to how we go about the idea of an Asian Jural Conclave and the ability of Lloyd's Law College and the tiny team we have been forming part of to reach out to the Asian countries. I saw today a news item in a newspaper being published from Kazakhstan, and that gave me a lot of excitement. Let me read a few paragraphs from this newspaper, because Kazakhstan will be one of those countries forming part of the Asian group of countries who would be invited over a period of time to be part of this Asian Jural Conclave. And this is what the newspaper reports. The report is dated on 27th of November 2021. And what has it got to say? It talks about the US Constitution, and comparison with the US Constitution is made over the nascent Kazakhstan Constitution, which was born in 1995. And this is what the newspaper says. The US Constitution is now, of course, well over 200 years old, but no one would doubt its relevance to modern America. It is something debated loudly and on an almost daily basis, the center of political life. But the importance of a constitution, as we have said before, is perhaps even greater to a young country like Kazakhstan than it is to those which have been shaped by many generations of independent nations. It helps identity shared values, provides a national purpose and roadmap for the future, is a role which is celebrated this week. Looking back over the years since our constitution was overwhelmingly approved, it's very clear how important it has been to our progress as a country. It has provided both the principles and mechanics which have enabled Kazakhstan to rise to every challenge it has faced. I think something of that sort would have been written way back in 1960s when India began experimenting with its own constitution. And that what probably every new country with its new constitution would be excited about and talking about, and how the constitution makes a difference to the lives of the people. Now, why do countries all over the world keep talking about their constitutions almost on a daily basis? As much as we keep talking about free air and clean environment, whether the idea of a constitution as a power organizing document has made any difference to the nation in terms of reorganizing their functioning as a nation, whether national histories under constitutional rule are fundamentally different from pre-constitutional histories. For India, a nation with thousands of years of venerable history. Its long philosophical, cultural, literary achievements and contribution to civilizational virtues. Has the Constitution added any new chapter for the existence of the nation? How do we therefore talk about living with the Constitution as if it is an embedded part of way of life in addition to or in substitution of moral and ethical precepts of religious belief? So the idea of a Jural, Asian Jural conclave is therefore a product of the set of gestations over a period, and as we would like to be part of an exciting emerging set of events all over the globe. So from SAARC to Asia and from Darawa to a global presence. And that is what Professor Menon always dreamed about. If the dreams of Professor Menon as making legal education more relevant, closer to the realities and needs of justice administration, and making it part of an integral part of a national movement towards excellence, I think we would be doing great, an important contribution by envisioning his ideas all over again, and then to be able to articulate new ways of realizing his visions. And his Asian Jural Conclave, in honor of Professor Menon, is one such very humble attempt. We have seen in the past, the 7 years of SAARC moot court competition, students have congregated here in Lloyd's and have gathered rich experiences. Every interaction with each and every one of us, judges, academicians, and a wide range of thought exchanges, I'm sure, had enabled and facilitated students to be able to, you know, arrive at deeper reflections on their role as a lawyer and their contributions as towards administration of justice, and at the bottom of it all, towards greater national excellence. And I'm sure with the advent of the Asian Jural Conclave, students will be now on a more wider canvas. We'll have more expansive cultural, religious, linguistic, and other amalgamation taking place. And I'm sure students from all over the Asian countries, more particularly India, with its rich contribution to legal education in the past 20 to 30 years, will be able to and should be keen to contribute to this event. Let me therefore welcome once again on this very exciting day of opening a new chapter in continuation of Professor Menon's visions. And let me welcome all the students and be open to be part of exciting events in the rest of your life. Do continue to revisit and visit this Lloyd's engagement in international and a global visions of legal education and making it closer towards administration of justice, which is a very complex subject in different parts of the world. But I'm sure events like this will be able to contribute towards them in a meaningful way. And let me congratulate the Lloyd's administration and all our wonderful team along with us, Professor Shivakumar, Lisa, Akhilesh Kumar, and Professor Salim, who worked tirelessly towards making these events a very exciting, you know, part of our so-called academic life. And thank you for your attention. Let me welcome all the dignitaries once again. Thank you.
Thank you for throwing light upon the competition, sir. Now, I, Pulak Mohanty, feel honored to welcome Professor Dr. Dilip Ukhe, Vice Chancellor of Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai, from 1st January 2019 onwards. Dr. Dilip Ukhe, after completion of his LLM in 1991 from the PG Department of Law, Nagpur University, was awarded Junior Research Fellowship by Department University Grants Commission and pursued research in the area of constitutional law, jurisprudence, and human rights. As a faculty at the Department of Law, Nagpur University, he started his teaching career with Indian Constitution as a basic subject. His academic endeavors and insights were rewarded by his appointment as a faculty in the prestigious Department of Law, University of Pune, 1993. Immediately, he was acclaimed as a legal distinguished and popular teacher and an academician by legal fraternity in and outside the university. Similarly, he was instrumental in redesigning the curriculum for LLM Pune University. His hard work and research output has paved the way for his appointment as a reader in the Department of Law 1997. I am honored to invite you, sir, to give the special address.
Thank you, Mr. Pulkit. Honorable Mr. Justice Surai Raja, Judge Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, Senior Advocate, Advocate Venkatramani, my dear friend and colleague, Professor Dr. Siva Kumar, the President of Lloyd, Mr. Manohar Tirani, the Director, Dr. Salim, Deputy Director, Dr. Akhilesh Khan, all the faculty members, dear students and participants, very good morning to all of you. At the outset, I compliment and congratulate Lloyd Law College and the organizers for organizing this 7th Professor N.R. Madhav Menon Asian Jural Conclave. As earlier speakers have pointed out, my association with also Professor Menon goes back to decades before, particularly when he was the member of Central State Relations Commission. During that time, rather, he had invited me at his residence at Delhi and discussed few things about the Central State Relations. As well, I had visited his residence at Kerala also and invited him in our department at Pune University. It's really a matter of great privilege to share with you all that at the time of my selection as a Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai, he was one of the members of the selection board, selection committee. And after the interview, I recollect that I was just crossing the room. He came out and patted at my back, saying only one word, excellent. Nothing beyond that. And I could get a clue that I'm going to be there with his blessings. He's a guru and mentor for all of us, and whatever we are today, we have learned a lot from Professor Padma Bhushan, now Professor N.R. Madhav Menon. When this Milat and the 7th Asian Jural Conclave was to be organized, Dr. Siva Kumar, a good friend of mine for several decades again, and I would say a great jurist, who has asked me, I said, anything in relation to Professor Menon, we can't say no to anything. And that's why, rather, I have given my consent. It is really indeed a great pleasure and privilege to be here with all of you. His work, particularly in the area of clinical legal education, as well as the criminal justice system, reforms in criminal justice system. We even now also refer to his reports. We now also refer to his books. We now also refer to his articles. And that's why he has been designated or branded as a father of modern legal education. The whole movement of the national law schools in India, the foundation stone was laid down by Professor Madhav Menon. And I'm really happy to know that from Professor, particularly Professor Siva Kumar, that his legacy is being carried out. His great work is being carried out by all of you. I really congratulate you and thank you for doing this service to the whole nation, to the whole country, to the whole fraternity of legal education as such. Dear friends, just yesterday we have celebrated the Constitution Day. And when we celebrate Constitution Day, just because we know that the 26th November 1949, the Constitution was adopted in the Constituent Assembly. And that's what rather the preamble also we read, that as it goes, we the people of India having solemnly resolved to constitute India into sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and an opportunity, and to promote amongst them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of individuals and unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1946, we do hereby adopt, enact, and give this constitution to ourselves. Usually, not only law institutions, legal institutions, but including now the government organizations, people, they do read this preamble every year on 26th day as it is being celebrated as the Constitution Day. However, what I feel that is merely reading the preamble enough. Moreover, we as law students generally tend to focus upon, emphasize upon, as we call it as a golden triangle, that is justice, liberty, and equality. Justice, social, economic, political, when Professor Menon had talked about clinical legal education, as well as the movement of national law universities was initiated by him. I happened to listen to him on some occasions. The basic purpose, basic aim of laying down the stone of national law universities movement, I am calling it as a movement, for the purpose of access to justice to all. And as well, even the aim according to him was of the clinical legal education was also the same. Whether now it is a matter of introspection for all of us, including myself, are we able to realize his dream? Are we able to realize his goal for which he stood for and worked throughout his life? Rather, still I remember, I think he was associated with one tribal university or organization in Chhattisgarh, which he had mentioned then, rather, when I visited his residence at Kerala. In view of this, when we talk about justice, now the time has come after 75 years of independence, freedom. We are celebrating 75 years as well as Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. We have got freedom from foreigners, from Britishers. But what I think that still we have to get freedom from several such things like poverty, like unemployment, like corruption, like discriminations, violences, violations, rampant violations of human rights. And that's what the real independence, real freedom is needed. And that's what the reason what I said and what I feel and I do say always, that usually we as law students tend to focus upon the golden triangle which has been ingrained in the preamble of the Indian Constitution, that is justice, liberty, and equality. Is that enough? Is it so that we tend to neglect, ignore, or even forget the another philosophy, another concept which is ingrained there, which came to be incorporated there then itself? To my mind, that is nothing but the soul of the Constitution. As we know, the Constitution is not only the supreme law of the land, but rather it is a vehicle, it is an instrument of the complete social transformation. And that too, after 75 years, we need to reassess, revisit that. And that is nothing but the notion of fraternity. Fraternity and assuring the dignity of individuals. Is it only the duty, is it only the job of the state to promote amongst all fraternity, or is it also our duty to adhere to to abide by. As we know that fraternity is nothing but the kind of a common brotherhood. What did we learn from this pandemic in this 1.5 year, or now will be closer to 2 years? The basic crux is of the humanity. And it is no longer a concept, it is no longer a philosophy, it is no longer just a principle which has been ingrained in the preamble. But rather, as we all of us know well, that Article 51A in the form of fundamental duties, Part 4A, which was incorporated by way of 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act in the year 1976. More importantly, under Article 51A, small e, which also obligates all of us to respect a common brotherhood, to follow the common brotherhood, as well as to respect the dignity of all individuals, as well to shun the violences against women and discriminations based on race, religion, region, etc., sectional diversities, as it is said. We are so much possessed with our rights, which are fundamentally guaranteed under Part 3. But duties which are there under Article 51A, earlier initially they were 10, now they are 11. And more importantly, Article 51A small e, in the form of common brotherhood, in the form of respecting the dignity of individuals. Dear friends, the young friends, young law students now competing, and they will pursue their profession. I urge that look at this integrated relationship, integral relationship between the notion of fraternity, which has been ingrained in the preamble, as well as the duty which has been casted upon all of us in the form of Article 51A small e. When we celebrate our 75 years and celebrating Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, we need to, as I said initially, we need to have that Azadi. We need to have that freedom. Freedom from discriminations based on all those things I do not wish to repeat. Then only it will be real Azadi. Then only it will be real freedom. Then only it will be real independence. And when we are celebrating Amrit Mahotsav, I'm in search of that Amrit. I'm in search of that elixir. That elixir of a peace. Elixir of real equality. Elixir of respect to human dignity. Elixir of real prosperity of all. When that day would come. Is it the duty of only the state? Is it only the duty of the government? Or we are also equally bound by these duties? I would call it as a dharma, our constitutional dharma, not only fundamental duty, our constitutional dharma. We need to enlighten our own conscience. This is not an occasion to say several things about such things, but nevertheless, I would like to appeal to all young brothers, young sisters, young generation, to introspect a bit, to think over this. Programs, research projects, publications, competitions, several things, they will come up. You will compete, you will participate, you will excel in your career also, in your profession also, whichever you might choose. But this basic mantra, a golden mantra, to my mind, that is the soul of the whole constitution. Notion of fraternity, common brotherhood, and assuring the dignity of individuals is the soul of the constitution. We need to respect that soul. And therefore, when you are now competing, no doubt one or the other team is going to win. But what is important is, not only in this competition, beyond the competition, and even thereafter in your future prospective lives, personal as well as professional, in those teams which are participating, there are rather, I am conscious enough, prospective advocate Venkat Ramani is, prospective advocate Harish Salve is, prospective judges of the Supreme Court, High Courts, Chief Justices, great professors like Professor Madhav Menons, prospective Professor Madhav Menons. If real homage, if it is to be paid to Professor N.R. Madhav Menon, that real homage would be this, to abide by this, our constitutional dharma, in the form of notion of fraternity as well as assuring the dignity of individuals. With this, I wish all of you, all the teams and participants, good luck, not only for the success in the competition, but rather to abide by these, to make some earnest effort to abide by this constitutional dharma, to pay the real homage to Professor Padma Bhushan N.R. Madhav Menon. With this, I thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity to share my thoughts, few thoughts. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir, for enlightening us. We are honored to have amongst us Honorable Mr. Justice Sitambaram Pillai Thurai Raja, Judge, Supreme Court of Sri Lanka. President's Counsel is a lawyer and a sitting puni justice of the Supreme Court of Sri Lanka. He was formerly a justice of the Court of Appeal of Sri Lanka and High Court of Fiji. Justice Thurai Raja qualified as an attorney at law in 1988 and joined the Attorney General's Department in 1989. He became Senior State Counsel, Deputy Solicitor General, and Additional Solicitor General, and was a High Court judge in Fiji. He was appointed President's Counsel in 2016. Justice Thurai Raja was appointed to the Court of Appeal in September 2016, becoming the first Indian Tamil to be appointed to the court. He was sworn in as a Justice of the Supreme Court on 9th January 2019. On behalf of everyone, I, Apurv Gautam, heartily welcome the chief guest of the event to give the inaugural address.
Respected judicial colleagues, Dr. Salim, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
We can hear you, sir.
Oh, lovely, lovely.
Thank you so much, sir.
Respected judicial colleagues and other judicial officers, Professor Dilip O.K., Professor Siva Kumar, beloved Mr. Manohar Thairani, and my most respected and ever chanting person, Mr. Venkat Ramani, Professor Lisa Lucas, and ever smiling Professor Mohammed Salim, other distinguished participants, parents, ladies and gentlemen, and my dear students. Good morning, Namaste, Namaskaram, Aibowan, and Vanakkam. We are gathered here in this inaugural session of Professor N.R. Madhav Menon Asian Jural Conclave, 7th Mooting Competition, Indian Round. I am greatly honored and privileged to be the chief guest of this important event. Thank you very much for the organizers for inviting me. I think I'm getting very closer to you all the time. It's a privilege, but I feel it's personal honor to me. I'm not here to share most serious thoughts today. Let us take it in lighter way, since all of you all been serious of starting the conference or the mood competition, and the serious things are there. So just want to touch a small important, but in a lighter way. Presently, unfortunately, we are preparing for exams. Most of us are qualified with lots of postgraduates, post-postgraduates, doctoral, and the other degrees. But unfortunately, do we have substantial people to compete? If I say it in a different form, how many advocates or the lawyers become a competent people, such as I'm not polishing of Mr. Venkatramani. I'm saying that how many people can become to that status and stature? Why? The reason is most of our children, in my personal view, are preparing for exams rather than studying the law or studying the subject in that case. Any subject, all of them are targeted to prepare an exam. Unfortunately, I'm not naming a software or anything. In China, most of these new tutorial programs are banned now because not only China, in many countries, because they say these are making the people to think in a way to prepare for the exams and to pass the exams, not to think independently. As you know, the South Asian countries, especially India, was a great country of invention. Mathematics, astronomy, space, sea warrior, whatnot. Everything is invented. Now, if you take any technology which was invented now was found in India. Now, we are talking about submarine. And I remember there's Tamil literature which I studied. I think 2500 BC, before Christ, it was on record. That is, some of the warriors were using submarines. They have seen the ships going under the water. That is, the poet says, she had seen the ship going under the water. That means, obviously, it's a submarine. When did we invent the submarine? Somewhere in 1927 and came into operation somewhere in 1940s. But how did we have this position of submarines 5,000 years ago? Now you take the temples, especially Mr. Venkatramani, Professor Sivakumar, and all will oblige. The sunlight exactly comes to that point on a certain day of the year. Exactly one day of that year, the sunlight comes to the main shrine in the temple. How did they calculate? There's a window. How did they calculate that so accurate? Even after 2,000 years, it happens. So that's an invention. That's a calculation. That's astronomy. Unfortunately, we lose everything. Where are we now? We work as a best laborer or virtually best employee in all those many of these developed countries. We follow the orders. We were in a position of inventing and we rule the world. But unfortunately, what we do now? We are virtually modernized slaves in different places. Maybe the money or other things involved. Now, we are also leading further to that by preparing for the exams. Unfortunately, we are in this vice, or maybe I might say this vicious trap. It's not vice, it's a vicious trap of preparing for exams. In this light, I really appreciate the organizers and the Lloyd School for organizing such an invention of involving in innovative ideas to come out. Of course, you can prepare for a moot. You can prepare, but you can't present a moot on somebody else's preparation. You have to be on your own to submit a moot. You can't stand. Mr. Venkatramani will appreciate there are lawyers who comes to court, but they can't stand for a few minutes because when the judge asks one or two questions, that's end. You can't be prepared. You have to be prepared. You can't be just memorized a submission. You have to be prepared. Right? So that is the ground idea of this. In my personal view, the mood and the other competition. So the children are ready to get into the new world. If I be permitted to say, they get into the lost ancient world. Let them be their own. That's one. The second idea is now, of course, there are about almost 300 to 400 participants here. And all of us at home and at different places, but we meet. How it happens? It's through the modern technology. Now, the information communication technology and this modern technology gives a different platform to us. Unfortunately, it's commercialized, and there's fortunate, there is some room for the innovative things also. Now, what happens? Even our grandmother can use this mobile in a highly advanced technology, use a highly advanced technology. I'm just getting into somebody else's network and buying a product. That's a high advanced technology. But what do? They have a phone. They don't know what is happening behind. They just touch a button and the person writing the program will write it in about 10-15 pages of that. But the grandmother makes a barfi or something, or even in that case, our respective wives, YouTubes and other things are helpful to make all these the dishes and the cookery items. Now, what happens? This is the better side of it. But the worst side is most of our children be addicted to the phones and the tablets and the computer. What happens? They are involved in the things by in a good way and a bad way. Good way is they are just went into the research items. Very few, only 5% according to the research, are involved in research and the study. The balance, 90% involved in entertainment ones. That comes to 5 plus 90 is 95. There is another 5% who are into the deep dark area of the internet. So this is where we go wrong. So virtually, if you put even 100%, what happens to the friends? We don't have physical friends. Unfortunately, if somebody dies, you get about 100 bouquets on the internet saying that I'm sorry, my deepest condolences. But nobody sends a bouquet to you. The worst is, if there is a birthday, there are 1,000 birthday wishes comes and cake photos and bouquet comes. But nobody gives even a single candy. So that's worst. So let us have physical friends with us. At this juncture, we are at a very unfavorable period of the recent history. Even though the technology help us to meet on the virtual platform, but we don't meet in people. I be permitted to say this. I had the privilege of visiting the Lloyd School in the presence of Mr. Manohar Thairani, Dr. Salim, and Professor Sivakumar, and Mr. Venkatramani, of course, didn't take me to the buildings, but the others took me to the buildings. And I saw how much it's the infrastructure. I'm not praising anybody. The infrastructure was so student friendly. There are a place to talk, there is a place to sit, there is a place to run. So what happens is this make you a perfect man. If you fall only, you know how to get up, right? We can't swim in a virtual platform. We have to get into the water to swim. So similarly, I wish all these participants are present physically in a place where they can improve, they can compete, contest, fight the combat as a brave soldier and accept its results as a gentleman. That brings us to the end. So I wish all the participants, contestants, best of luck, and especially congratulate the Lloyd School and the organizing team. All the best. Hope to see you soon in person. Thank you. Vanakkam.
Thank you so much, sir, for enlightening us with your words of wisdom. Now, I would like to request Professor Dr. Mohammad Salim to propose the vote of thanks.
Good morning and very warm welcome to our respected chief guest of the inaugural function, Honorable Mr. Justice S. Thurai Raja, Judge Supreme Court of Sri Lanka. Our guest of honor of the program, Professor Dr. Dilip Uke, Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National University, Mumbai, and Mr. Manohar Thairani, President, Lloyd Law College, Chairperson, Founding Committee, Professor N. R. Madhavanan, Asian Jural Conclave, Mr. N. R. Venkatramani, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India, Co-Chairperson, Professor N.R. Madhavan and Asian Jural Conclave, Professor Dr. S. Sivakumar, Senior Professor, Indian Law Institute, New Delhi, former member, Law Commission of India, honorary Asian Jural Conclave Administrator, Professor Dr. Lisa P. Lukos, Professor Guru Govind Singh, Indraprastha University, Treasurer Milat, National Administrator, India, eminent dignitaries, judges of the competition, faculty members, and dear students. I have been given the responsibility to propose word of thanks to all in the event of Professor N.R. Madhavanan Asian Jural Conclave 2021-22 and 7th Professor N.R. Madhavanan Asian Mooting Competition India Round. It is a matter of great pleasure and pride for me to offer the word of thanks at this competition, which has the name of Professor Menon associated with it. The event, which was conceptualized in the presence of Professor Menon, in the life of Professor Menon, on the guidance of Professor Menon, and which is blessed by his presence in the first four editions. The competition has always aimed at engaging and inspiring students. Today, as the chief guest of this competition, we are obliged and honored by the presence, by the gracious presence of Honorable Mr. Justice S. Thurai Raja, Judge Supreme Court of Sri Lanka. Lordship's very presence here indicates his interest and keenness to encourage new talents and his involvement in the innovative ways to engage their students and to improve their professional skills. His professional journey is itself a learning lesson for all the new lawyers in India, Sri Lanka, Asian region, South Asian region, and globally. Honorable Lordship, I and on behalf of Lloyd Law College extend our heartfelt word of thanks for gracing this function and sharing with this young audience your vision, your perspectives, and your ways of thinking, and how you always try to incite new ideas in the minds of all of us. I would like to offer my sincere gratitude to our guest of honor of the day, Professor Dr. Dilip Uke, Vice Chancellor, Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai. Sir, your vision of creating a futuristic academic culture in Indian legal landscape is in varied fields of law is commendable. On behalf of Lloyd Law College, I promise that we too shall try and walk along in taking forth your vision for the generation of lawyers to come. Thank you, sir. I extend my deepest gratitude to Mr. Manohar Thairani, sir, President, Lloyd Law College, Chairperson, Founding Committee, Professor N.R. Madhavanan, Asian Jural Conclave, for his untiring support and his continuous motivation to all of us. It is with your support and guidance that we are able to fathom newer challenges in the field of law, legal education, law school teaching, learning of students, student support, and moving forward to providing the immense and variable support to all the student fraternities in India. Thank you, sir. I would like to offer my sincere gratitude to Mr. R. Venkatramani, Senior Advocate, Supreme Court of India. Sir, it is with your untiring zeal, your continuous commitment towards the students of law, legal fraternity, lawyers, judges, everyone who has a thinking process about law, and your added newer landmarks each year to this quoted events, and your guidance, your support, you're always marking the ideas, you're always marking the benchmarks for all of us, is an immense support for all of us. Thank you, sir. I extend my deepest gratitude to our guide, Professor Dr. S. Sivakumar, sir, Senior Professor, Indian Law Institute, New Delhi, former member, Law Commission of India, honorary Asian Jural Conclave Administrator. It is with sir's energy and enthusiasm that we are able to take forth Professor Menon's vision in the area of mooting and academic exchange in India, South Asia, all of Asia, and the global levels. This is not the only platform where Professor Dr. S. Sivakumar, sir, is trying to mandate the vision of Professor Menon, sir. And this is not the only platform where sir is trying to mandate the vision of Professor Menon, sir, to the students. He is trying to make sure in a lot of events in India, a lot of events in Asia, South Asia, and globally. Sir is the true torch bearer of the spirit and vision and guidance which is provided by Professor Menon to all the legal fraternity in India. We are extremely blessed to have Sir's presence and guidance all together throughout these competitions and way in future. Thank you so much, sir. I also extend my heartfelt gratitude to Professor Dr. Lisa Pilukos, Professor IP University, Treasurer Milat, National Administrator India. Ma'am's continuous guidance and support and her untiring commitment to academics has always been very inspiring for all of us. And her always being keenly observing and making things possible at all levels. This is only possible with the support and guidance. This is only possible by her driving this competition to the better levels every year, every term, every session. Thank you so very much, ma'am. Last but not the least, I wish to thank Dr. Anand Maria, Mr. Robin Jacob, Dr. Akhilesh Kumar Khan, Professor Navneet Kumar, organizing committee, IT members, all my student volunteers, all my staff members, my faculty members. This is my pleasure and privilege that I'm working with all of you and I'm learning with all of you. I would like to thank all of you. Thank you so much. With this, I seek the permission of our chief guest of the program and our guest of honor of the program to close the inaugural ceremony of the program. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind words.